Cooper Webb, and I choose OGF.
I'm Christian Craig.
I'm Dean Wilson.
I'm Aaron Plessinger.
I'm Darren Martin.
I'm Nate Thrasher.
I'm Shane McElrath.
I'm Hunter Lawrence.
My name's Jared Lawrence.
I'm Jordan Smith.
I'm Talon Hawkins.
Sergey Hampshire.
I'm Hayden Deegan.
I'm Cole Nichols, and I choose OGF.
And I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
I'm Tom Bial, I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
I'm Jillian Ferrandis, and I choose OGO.
Oh, it was good. Pretty rough qualifying for me, 33rd. Just struggled with bike setup in the track a little bit, but turned it around for the motos, P15 and P18, so P14 overall. Personal best for me and personal best in the 450. So yeah, I'm stoked. Building blocks and track was gnarly for sure. And I liked it though, it was good.
It's been quite the first year, you know, dude, to think where you were even just at Loretta's 2 years ago, however it is, and to be where this is now and top 20 450 guy. How is it?
Yeah, so just like I said, just building blocks and like Loretta's and amateurs is a lot different just because you have maybe like 5-10 guys that are really good and then pros like there's 20 to 30, you know, like everyone's good and we're all just duking it out. But I'm stoked at my progress, especially just from last year. So just looking forward to keep building forward and just hopefully get better each weekend and just stay healthy all season.
Yeah, kudos to the track crew. They gave us a challenging course. I had a lot of fun for sure. It's, you know, I think I'm capable of a little bit more results-wise, but I'm happy with overall how the day went. Definitely step in the right direction.
What did you think of the track today? I mean, we've been here so many times, they always tweak something about the layout, so it was interesting to see this top of the hill get tightened up, it seemed, but then this side over here get way more opened up.
Yeah, I think you hit the nail on the head. It's super tricky up in that area. It's kind of like make or break in some of those ruts. You can lose a second easily just by like standing your bike up. I think as far as like obstacles go, this year was a little easier than last year, and conditions, it was definitely harder this year. So it's kind of like offset. I think there's a few tricky sections last year where it was like, like the wall jump and there's just a couple other jumps that made it tough. But now I think this year is like, you know, you had way more bumps and ruts to have to deal with.
Today, I went 10-10 for ninth overall, which is good. I should be happy with that. It's consistent, but I'm really disappointed. I had two good starts in both of the motos, and I kind of went backwards. I didn't gel well today with the track and myself and the bike and everything. So definitely struggled today, but it was a good salvage weekend, to put it that way. No falls, good start. So there was a lot of positives to take away from it. I just think I should have been where I started. So Moto 1, I started in fourth. You know, I feel like I should have finished right 4-5. Second moto around, I started around 7th, so I feel like I should have finished around those spots, and I didn't. So that's the biggest disappointment. But overall, it was still a positive weekend. I learned some stuff, some more stuff with the bike. I learned some more stuff with myself and my riding. And like I said, I had good starts. So that's a key right there. So we'll keep building on that. I'm excited to go east now. I think that should be good. Just really excited for Red Bud here pretty soon. It'll be good for a weekend off as well. I can do some more riding and kind of just try to gel. So, but overall, I moved up in points as well. So I'm sitting 7th in points, which is really good. So we'll just keep building on it.
Okay, you've raced here a lot over the years. What do you think of the track changes this year and how did it affect you?
Yeah, so I think the layout was like this last year too, though I didn't race here last year. I prefer the old layout they had. I think all these kind of turns up and down, it just doesn't have a good flow to it. I know it was pretty fast of a track before, but I would say like the track crew seemed to have done a pretty good job, you know, prepping the track and whatnot. It was certainly gnarly as heck today. They definitely ripped it deep, watered it a lot. So that was That was gnarly, but you know, it's the same for everyone. So I do normally like coming here. It's normally a fun track for me. But yeah, so just gotta keep on keeping.
Do you have a Suzuki on the East Coast right now? Or have you been going back and have you been in California the whole time?
Yeah, so the first two rounds I stayed in California and I flew back after Hangtown. So this week leading into this weekend, I got to ride and practice at home. So from now on, I'll fly in and out or fly home every weekend, which is nice. So it's nice to be home and ride a Club MX every weekend and ride with those guys. So I think we're just going to keep going up from here and build on it. I've said it before, I don't really have a lot of time on the bike yet. So like today was like day number 10 on the bike. So the more time, the better. And yeah, I'm excited what the future will be with the team and everything, and going forward with 8 more rounds, right? So we got lots of rounds left.
7.
Well, we got 11 rounds, right? We done 3?
We did 3. So I don't know. I'm bad at that. That's why I do this.
Okay, yeah, so then we got a lot of rounds left.
Yeah, you got a lot of motos. You're good. Okay, so then last question. How does the yellow bike feel on the East Coast? You know, a little stickier, a little ruddier, a little softer. How is it?
Yeah, so at Club, we have kind of a sandier base, to put it that way. I really enjoy the bike. It feels really good at home. And we have a really good base setting. And I think the more I can test as well, we're going to kind of fine-tune that and kind of find that little extra. You know, everyone's going extremely fast. So to find that little extra, you kind of have to be, you know, gel perfectly. So more time, I think I'm going to get there, and it will be good. And the Twisted T-Stick team has been doing phenomenal so far. They certainly have my back, so I'm excited about that.
Yeah, first of all, I'd love to give the glory to God on that one. It's been a rough couple of years, and yeah, just been believing in his plan, believing in the team around me, and all that. So but yeah, track was very gnarly today, and I was just focusing on myself, but yeah, track got really, really, really gnarly.
Okay, second moto, I'm sitting on the hill and I'm like, whoa dude, what's going on? And yeah, I'm hearing the lap times are faster, and then you're just making ground. And that battle you had with Dylan, and then you got around Cooper, just everything you guys were doing, Ty, you look like you were in the zone. How much fun was that?
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. I mean, a lot of respect for these guys. I mean, they're crazy good, and I was made it easier on myself. The second moto, got a good start. First moto, I fell down first corner, so I was dead last, came to fifth. And then this moto, made it a little bit easier on myself, but yeah, I mean, a lot of respect for these guys. I was bummed at first that Dylan got me that last lap. But, I mean, this shows you how good these guys are. I mean, they hold that pace until the last lap. They don't let off. A lot of respect for them. A little bummed at first, but, I mean, very good day. And, a lot of respect for these guys.
Okay, what happened on the last lap? Because I didn't see it. I saw you come by because I was by the finish line, and there was a good gap. And then Dylan came by at the checkered flag before, and I was like, oh, okay.
Yeah, I mean, he was just charging hard. I haven't looked at lap times. If I was dropping off, I was kind of struggling with the lines a little bit. Track was changing so much. And yeah, I mean, Dylan just straight up passed me around the outside. I don't know if the outside was better, if he just made it work. I have to watch a video on it. But yeah, he did it. Tried coming around the outside here. But yeah, he just straight up got me. I have probably like 3 corners to go.
Ty, this was cool to be by the podium. Hear everybody psyched on you. I know everybody online is psyched. I'm sure the comments on your posts and our posts are going to be going good. So carry this on through the summer. People are going to be very happy for you.
Oh, yeah. Appreciate it.
It's not easy day again. Practice, I struggled a little bit on the track. It was very muddy, but I was pretty confident for the race. And yeah, good start in the first moto. And yeah, we in the first lap, we different line with AP, and the line finished together, and yeah, big contact, and we both crashed. So yeah, that was unfortunate, and my bike was on him, so I had to help him to go out. So I lose some time, and yeah, he restarted before me, and I had to turn over my bike and like do a 360 and whatever. So yeah, I lose some time, was dead last, and yeah, came back 7, but yeah, was a struggle. And yes, second moto, better, a good start, and struggled a little bit early in the moto. Like I hurt my shoulder a little bit. I was kind of cold, and it took me a few laps to get warm. And yeah, after that was fine. But yeah, came back P3. Yeah, it's okay, but yeah, it sucks to not win.
It was a good battle though. Like I was watching everything to see what was going on, and then for you to get Ty on the last lap, I had no idea, because I can't wait to see this. I hope there's footage of it. He said you passed him around the outside.
Yeah, actually the corner where I crashed with AP in first moto, that's where I passed him in the very last lap. I mean, yeah, he rode great. Like it's amazing for him to have as a privateer to be where he was. So congrats to him. But yeah, you know, my goal is to do the best every moto. So there is no, like if there's no opportunity, I take it.
All right, last thing, second in points.
DK.
Second, I know. Second in points, not bad. It's going pretty good.
What's second in point?
You're second in points.
I don't even know.
Oh, okay. So it's not that important. Yeah. Just keep doing motos.
I mean, when the other guy do a six win in a row, you know, the gap is big, so that sucks. So I don't, being second in point, it's not fun for me. I don't ride for this. So I will keep trying, and I need to win.
Said though, like second in points, yeah, he's got a gap on you, and it's been six wins, but you're getting right back to where you need to be, and maybe a month ago it wasn't going to be this way.
Yeah, for sure. Like I said in a previous interview, I'm rebuilding myself after what happened in Supercross this season. So it's better to be second in point now than in the hospital a few months ago. So that's for sure. But for me, it's just not fun not winning. You know, that's what I've been trying to do all my life. And it's been three races I don't win. So it's just very hard to accept. And every morning I wake up with that goal, and when you cannot reach your goal, it's not easy. So yeah, you have to accept it and keep training and keep working hard.
Yeah, it was a tough day, to be fair, but was well rewarded in the end with a podium. But yeah, it was good, man. This place is tough for me. I usually struggle here, so practice wasn't too great, anything special. First moto was good. Obviously, some stuff happened and put myself in a good situation to capitalize. And then, I struggled that second one straight up, just with myself a little bit. I kind of ran out of steam, and I was struggling a little bit with just flow and everything. So happy to be able to walk away with the third overall.
What do you think about the track changes that they made today? Some spots a little bit tighter, some spots way faster than they used to be.
I actually, like the layout itself and the way it got, I was a big fan of. It was really gnarly. I'm not quite, you know, there fitness-wise and riding-wise to be able to really ride the track the way it needs to be ridden, but I thought the track was well prepared and well prepped, and the layout was good, and there was passing today, there was great spots, and I thought they did a great job.
You know, the summer is going to be a work in progress, but even watching today, from my perspective, it looks like you're riding well, looks like you're tucking into tighter lines and moving around a lot. It's not like you're just stuck. So it seems like everything's going well enough that you're like, oh yeah, dude, there's progress to be made through these next few weeks.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think, from round one to last weekend to now, it's all progress. So I'm happy. I mean, I've had no expectation for these first few, and you know, I'm exceeding my expectations, so I'm happy with that. We're in a good battle with second place at points already, and that's a good thing, you know, and we're stacking off good points for the SMX, and we've been on the podium twice, which I didn't think I would do at all, so this soon, I should say, but I'm happy, and like I said, I think once we have our first break and by Red Bud, I should be where I'd like to be, but for the time being, we'll keep grinding and get better.
Yeah, it was pretty good. Third round now, consistently hit the ground every time. But that being said, first moto went harder than expected. Didn't see Dylan, and took that inside line. I figured, you know, I'll do a 2-for-1, and then all of a sudden, boom, we both went down. And yeah, I was as surprised as he was, but got up, gritted my way back to fourth, second moto, got a decent start, had to do some battling, got up to second, and kind of just chilled out there. Held the gap pretty good from me to Jet, and then ultimately I just kind of backed it down and just said, you know, I don't want to hit the ground again, so just cruise it for second, and that's what I did. And first podium of the season, so pumped on that, but I think maybe go back this week, do some homework, and come back at High Point and try and have something for Jet.
What did you think of the track changes today? I've asked everybody, so what were your thoughts on spots that were faster, spots that are slower, and just the overall flow?
I've always liked this place, you know, the changes. I really liked how it went before they like changed that like gator tail before, you know, the mechanics area, like when they went and did that sharp left and then the sharp right in the mechanics area and then back and then did the big tabletop down there. I really like that layout, but this one's pretty cool too. It gets really rough, obviously really rutted. I like that they took out that, you know, that big steep double in the middle. That was sketchy. But, you know, I liked it. Overall, it was good. I had a good day. Like I said, first podium of the season, and I'm pumped.
Right. Good run of races coming up. I mean, we're going east, right where you want to be. So how excited are you right now, and what's the plan?
Yeah, man. Plan is to just keep doing work. Keep working hard, and hard work usually pays off. So the main goal is to get closer and try to beat Jet. He's a man right now, so I'm going to try to knock him off the pedestal and keep him from, you know, doing that 20-0. So that's the main goal. But overall, just head back to Alden's, do the work, and come back swinging for High Point.